हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू फिजिकल साइंस डिजिटल क्लासेस। मैं बोवाद, माई सेल्फ नरेंद्र बाबू कोटला, पीजीटी केमिस्ट्री टीएसएमएस महबूबाबाद। टुडे रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट एट कर्व्ड सरफेसेस, क्लास 10 पार्ट 4। इन दिस वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट फॉर्मेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ इमेजेस बाय कॉन्वेक्स लेंस। Types of images formed by a convex lens depends on the position of the object in front of the lens. The types of images formed by a convex lens generally depends on the where the object is placed in front of the lens. That means the position of the object placed in front of the lens. And we can place the object at different positions, that means different distances from a convex lens to get different types of images. So we can place the object at a different positions from a convex lens to get different types of images. First one, the object placed between optic center and F. If you place the object between the optic center and F, what happens and how the image will form, we will see. For that purpose, first let me move between the optic center and F. Let me move between optic center and F. If you place the object between optic center and F, now I am the object here. The light rays which passes parallel to the principal axis, the light rays which passes parallel to the principal axis after incident on the convex lens, refraction takes place and passes through the focus. And after refraction, they passes through the focus. Second light ray, the light ray which incident on the optic center without any deviation, it passes in straight line. Both these light rays are, they do not intersect each other on the right side. Both these light rays, that means both these refracted light rays, they do not intersect on right side. If you extend these light rays back, if you extend these light rays back, these two light rays will meet at a point, and at that point, it forms the image. This forms the image. The image is larger than the object. So the image that forms behind the object, that means I am the object, behind the object the image will be formed. The image is virtual and erect image. So this image is magnified image, that means larger than the object. Second one, the object placed at F. If you place the object at F, what happens we will see. Let me move towards the focus. The light rays which are parallel to the principal axis after incidenting on the convex lens, they passes through the focus. Light rays which are parallel to the principal axis after refraction, they passes through the focus. The second light ray which incident on the optic center without any deviation, the passes through the optic center. The second light ray without any deviation that passes through the optic center. Both these light rays, refracted light rays, they do not meet each other. They meet at infinity. That means the image that forms at infinity. If you place the object at F, the image that forms at infinity distance. That means the image that forms at infinity, the image formed is real and inverted. The image is highly magnified image that forms. Third one, object placed between the center of curvature C2 and focal point F2. If you place the object between the center of curvature C2 and focal point F2. That means let me shift between F2 and C2. The light rays which are parallel to the principal axis after incident on the convex lens, it passes through the focus. The light rays which passes parallel to the principal axis after refraction, they passes through the focus. The light rays which passes parallel to the principal axis after refraction, they passes through the focus. Second light ray that passes through the optic center without any deviation. The second light ray passes through the optic center without any deviation. And these two light rays, they meet at a point. At that point, it forms the image. These two light rays, they meet at a point, and that point is beyond the C1. And beyond the C1, it forms the image. The image formed is beyond the C1. The image formed beyond the C1. The image is real and inverted image that forms. The image size is larger than the object. It is magnified image it forms. The image formed is magnified image. Object placed at center of curvature. Object placed at center of curvature. C2. Let me move towards the C2. If you place the object at C2, the light rays which passes parallel to the principal axis, the light rays passes parallel to the principal axis, incident on the convex lens, undergoes refraction and passes through the focus. Second light ray that passes through the optic center without any deviation. Second light ray passes through the optic center without any deviation. The two refracted light rays, they meet at a point. At that point, it forms the image. These two refracted light rays meet at point, and that point is at C1. That means the image that forms at C1. If you place the object at C2, the image formed is at C1. The image is real and inverted. The image is real and inverted. And the size of image is same as object. The image size is same as object. Fifth one, object placed beyond the center of curvature. That means we have to move beyond the C2. Now, the object placed beyond the center of curvature. The light rays which passes parallel to the principal axis, incident on the convex lens, and after refraction, they passes through the focus. The light rays which passes parallel to the principal axis, after refraction, they passes through the focus. The second light ray which incident on optic center without any deviation, they passes in the same direction. The second light ray which passes through the optic center without any deviation. These two light rays, means these two refracted light rays, meet at a point, and at that point it forms the image. If you place the object beyond the C2 center of curvature, the image formed between F1 and C1. Between the F1 and C1, the image will be formed. The nature of image is real and inverted. The image is real and inverted. And the image type is diminished image, smaller than the object. The image that forms, that is smaller than the object. Sixth one, object at infinity. If you place the object at infinity, we cannot be able to show the object clearly here in this case. So that means, so the parallel rays from top point of distant object, incident on the convex lens, and after refraction, they moves like this. And one more light ray which is passing through the optic center without any deviation, it passes through this and it meets at focus. And it forms the image at focus. Now, the image formed is at the focus. The image is real and inverted. So, the image is much smaller than the object. Like this, it forms the image. And overview. Position of the object, position of the image, size of the object, nature of image. If you place the object within focus, the image that forms same side as object, the size of image is enlarged and the nature of image is virtual and erect. If you place the object at focus, the image that forms at infinity and size of image is highly enlarged and the nature of image is real and inverted. If you place the object between focus and center of curvature, it forms the image beyond C1, that means beyond center of curvature. Size of image is enlarged. Nature of image is real and inverted. If you place the object at center of curvature, that means at C2, the image that forms at the center of curvature at C1, the image same as or same size as object. Nature of image is real and inverted. If you place the object at C2, the position of image between F1 and C1, size of image is diminished. Nature of image is real and inverted. If you place the object at infinity, the position of image is at focus. The size of image is highly diminished. Nature of image is real and inverted. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.